Welcome to the MasterCars Pro channel. Today we will talk about the problems and weaknesses of this wonderful car. We're starting with the power units as usual. 2-liter turbo and non-turbo engines are the most popular motors on i40 Hyundai. These engines are well known on other Hyundai models. Gas GDI 1.6-liter and diesel CRDI 1.7-liter are not so common. All of those engines require timing chain replacement at 150 to 200,000 km. 2-liter engines have hydraulic valve clearance regulation system. Issues are connected with engine noise operation. Oil change helps reducing noise levels. Some cases require hydraulic valve lifters replacement. Cylinder head gasket seal may have oil leakages at 100,000 of kilometerage. Replacement helps. 2-liter engines have risk of early horn surface scratching. Signs are knocking sounds and high oil consumption. Rare i40 owners can face this problem though. 1.6-liter engines could get blown at low mileage about 100,000 km. Repairs were made free in terms of guarantee. Engine's resource can be over 150,000 km with regular service. Diesel i4s did not do well in Russia. These engines are very fuel sensitive, so problems may appear on EGR, injection pump, and injectors. Diesel engines' maintenance is much more expensive than of gasoline ones. Engine often refuses to start and produces heat at low temperatures. Turbocharger is also weak and expensive. 6-speed manual and auto and 7-speed dual clutch automated transmission are available for i40. Korean DSG analog 7-speed transmission may have clutch set to be replaced already at 50 to 70,000 km. Transmission kicks will indicate that. Automated transmission is well rigid. Some cars with that transmission have over 200,000 km on their odometers. Some kicks may still appear. Particular ATF change can solve this. Manual transmission is also good, except flywheel and both clutch cylinders. This component's failure causes difficulties with gear shifting. Clutch can make it to 150 to 200,000 km. Suspension has some issues. Shock absorbers, torsion bar links, and wheel bearings feel bad at 60 to 80,000 km. Ball joints fail at 100,000 km and replaced in assembly with wishbone. Outer CV joints can cause problems. Rear independent suspension can operate for 100 to 150,000 km. Camber link bushings can be replaced without links. Steering rack bearings are also under risk. EPS-powered steering column can produce some noises. Rack and column are replaced for free under guarantee, but have a short lifetime of 30 to 50,000 km. Brakes are pretty durable, but electro-handbrake can make rear brake pads replacement procedure a little more difficult. Interior is performed in Hyundai style with premium materials. Shifter level and steering wheel rim, however, get scratchy rather quickly. Central tunnel plastic panels are also worn in a short time. Front panel produces sounds and early cars. Seat material also gets worn quickly. Driver seat side pillows quickly lose shape under people of over 90 kg weight. Electronics have some issues with sustainable operation. Rear view cameras were not sealed properly, so water and dust could easily get inside, damaging camera electronics. Cameras cost from 30 to 350 euros from different manufacturers. Air conditioning can unexpectedly stop working during a long drive. Vaporizer icing is the reason. Adding resistive elements in control wiring helps addressing that issue. It may also be caused by auto conditioning pump fault. Pump valve, however, can be replaced separately. Paint job is traditionally thin and soft, so cars become scratched at low mileage.
Well, if you are the owner of this car, then please describe the problems that you had to face during the operation of the car. Perhaps it is your feedback that will help viewers when choosing a car. That's it for today. Thanks everyone for attention. It isn't much work for you to subscribe to the channel. See you soon.